The cast of Real Estate Agents on Selling Sunset have toured some of LA's most extravagant homes over the years, so they must know a thing or two about finding the right property. Let's take a look at how their own homes compare.
This is like dream home material.
Chrishell Stouse. The main star of the show may have less real estate experience compared to her fellow peers, but you won't be able to tell with this gorgeous house that she picked out for herself. After her divorce with ex-husband Justin Hartley, Chrishell was relieved to be finally investing in something that would not leave her. She picked out this single-story, $3.3 million Hollywood Hills mansion built in 1964 that's 0.36 acres big and complete with 4 bedrooms and 5 bathrooms, perfect for inviting guests over. It has a gas fireplace, gourmet kitchen, and a sliding glass door in the master bedroom that opens up to the pool. The dining and sitting area opens up to the backyard as well, as the indoor-outdoor design is very on trend in LA. Her backyard comes with a spa seating area and dual fireplaces. Very extravagant. The outside has LED energy-efficient lighting, it's surrounded by lush greenery, and has an amazing view of the canyon and the city.
I mean, if I did have a client named Lisa, I'm sure she would love this house too because it's amazing.
If you're thinking of purchasing a similar house, just know that it comes with $43,000 in property taxes per year. We love that the home is chic and modern, just like Chrishell.
It's the first time that I have ever been in a position to be able to buy my own home.
In the latest season, she even hinted at having a baby room one day, so perhaps the place would be renovated even further in the future. Christine Quinn. The diva on the show definitely has the home to reflect her personality. Christine, with her husband Christian, a retired tech entrepreneur, purchased a 5,917 square feet, 3-story Hollywood Hills mansion that has 5 bedrooms, 7 bathrooms for $5 million in January of 2019. The home has stunning views of LA, an infinity pool, and of course a walk-in closet that can fill 400 Louboutin shoes. It doesn't get more Christine than that. The real estate agent mentions that her closet is where she gets a lot of deals done.
So this is where a lot of deals really get done in this room.
The interior is made up of dark palettes with gold accents. I mean, what else can we expect from someone who wore a black wedding dress? Other interior pieces that we must mention are their custom Desaid sofa, which took 7 months to make in Switzerland, a life-sized tortoise sculpture, a large marble dining table, and a tiger in the backyard, because of course she does. Last but not least, they also have a game room with a skee ball machine, air hockey, popcorn machine, a bar, and a neon sign outline of her figure, complete with a cozy movie theater.
Dreams really do come true.
Heather Ray Elmusa. The house was first purchased by Heather and her husband Tarek, the star of Flipping 101, as a potential renovation project for $3.125 million, but they decided to keep it for themselves. Their primary residence is located in Newport Beach, in the desirable neighborhood of Eastside Costa Mesa. It was built in 2015, spans 3,000 square feet, has 4 beds, 5 baths, and a wood fence surrounding the property. It features a contemporary living area with high-sloped ceilings, a very white kitchen, a glammed-up fireplace, and the entire house is an automated smart home. The exterior also features a pool and a spa, an outdoor kitchen and fire pit, and glass sliders that go out to a poolside terrace. Sounds perfectly cozy for the couple. Jason Oppenheim. The broker has seen just about the most luxurious homes in the city, and his own bachelor pad is nothing short of spectacular. He lives in a $10 million Hollywood Hills crib that's complete with 3 bedrooms, a floating stairwell, a fireplace that you can see from both the inside and out, a bar, and a misting system. His living area has an 85-inch TV that comes straight out of the ground with the press of a button. He also has an antique phone that was collected from a World War II boat that had to have wiring installed around the house to make it work.
But it works.
His dining room consists of chairs that cost $6,500 each. His kitchen isn't used very often, but he does have a $16,000 coffee maker that is mainly for show because he has to hire a barista to operate it anytime he wants coffee.
At this point, I feel like I deserve to just,
overspend, do something the way that I want to.
After the airing of Selling Sunset, Jason really learned to value his privacy, so he decided to incorporate hundreds of ficus trees in the surrounding area, as well as an expensive alarm system that goes around the whole perimeter, where there would be a live person watching if someone crosses the boundary. To balance all of the steel in the house, he has a tree in the middle of his home. It's definitely a unique house for sure. Mary Fitzgerald. One of the top-selling real estate agents at the Oppenheim Group actually has the most modest place. Her current home that she shares with her husband, Romaine, is rented in the Valley Village area and has 3 bedrooms. It's a quiet neighborhood located in a gated community, as the security was an important aspect for her.
But it works somehow.
The home has an industrial design vibe that comes with a fireplace, a bar, a fully equipped gym, and has an outdoor space with a little fountain. It's decorated with gold crown art, lamps, and an espresso coffee maker that Mary cannot live without. Maya Vander. This mom shares her Miami home with her husband and 2 children. In her home tour with Cosmopolitan, Maya shows off her large kitchen space with a big countertop, her walk-in closet that features basic fashion styles as she would describe, a master bedroom with dual sinks, and a large bathtub that she doesn't have time to use. What a practical home for a practical mindset. Amanza Smith. This interior designer's home has furniture that's mostly DIY. She designed her own big green sofa, her rug, the chairs, and the cupboards.
But it's so comfortable and it's so soft. And I designed it, so I love it.
Her closet has some funky clothes that she likes to show off that reflect her artsy personality. Amanza lives in the home with her kids. Emma Hernan. She may be the new girl on the team, but that doesn't mean she doesn't have taste. In season 4, we can spot Emma hanging out by a massive pool that gives you a glimpse of the LA canyons and glamorous city views. This mansion is worth $7 million and has 3 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms and is located on the Sunset Strip. However, Emma doesn't own this place, as she's only here while her own house is being renovated. Still, this place costs $35,000 a month to rent. Jason Oppenheim. Looking at houses all day, just one house wouldn't satisfy the owner of the Oppenheim Group. He recently purchased a $7 million Newport Beach mansion that's 12,579 square feet, complete with 6 bedrooms and 8 bathrooms. Its lot size is massive, as it is 0.61 acres big. His favorite rooms in the house are the movie theater and game room, which has a ping pong table, pool table, and a foosball table. Where do we sign up to be his friend? This house, too, has an enhanced security system and is protected behind gates. It has 2 garages that's big enough to hold 11 cars. The house also comes with a full gym, a wine cellar, and a dog washing station. The gourmet kitchen is complete with a leathered granite countertop, plus a butler's pantry. The outdoor kitchen, yes I said outdoor kitchen, is 1,500 square feet and it has an oversized glass fridge, ice machine, and a built-in barbecue set. We really couldn't have asked for anything more in a house. His new home likely isn't renovated to its maximum potential yet, but if it's anything like his old house, we know it's going to be filled with amazing artifacts. Heather Ray Almusa. Heather and Tarek also bought a cabin in the San Bernardino Mountains next door to her parents' place. It's the first house the couple has designed and built from scratch. It has 2 bedrooms and a small bathroom, a loft that's up a set of ladders where the kids would sleep, and a cozy-looking fireplace. Looks like a fun vacation spot for sure. To be able to sell lavish homes to clients, we guess they must first have impeccable taste themselves. While some choose to maximize their extravagance, others would rather live on a more toned-down lifestyle. So which house is your favorite? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel if you want to stay up to date on the latest reality TV news, and we'll see you next time on The Things Reality.